A bike lane battle heating up at City Hall. The question now is if Cincinnati leaders will backpedal on a plan to bring a bike lane to Central Parkway. Good evening, everyone. I'm Mike Dardis.
And good evening to you. I'm Cherie Palello. Supporters say this is all about progress, or others are worried about the toll on traffic safety as well as business. John London is live at City Hall tonight where cyclists are making their case. John.
Yeah, Cherie, today was a battle in search of balance, a controversy that came to compromise, but after all the opinions about dedicating a bike lane, the wheel of compromise could come off. The bike lane battle is centered right around here along Central Parkway, where Tim Haynes has several business tenants. Take away a parking lane and let bicycle riders use it, Haynes said, and you drive business and growth away.
If you were by the building on a day like today, you're going to see 35 to 45 cars parked, you know, scattered about on both sides.
Bike enthusiasts who rode in to set up temporary camp in front of City Hall today say, look, a protected bike lane will make everything safer along one of the few flat streets that connect core neighborhoods.
I think the plan that they have it as now preserves parking for the most part.
Upstairs, the bureaucrats took it to compromise level, presenting a PowerPoint that offered options like ramping a portion of the bike lane off the street and onto a lawn. You'd lose up to a couple dozen trees, but the parking would be preserved.
I'm appalled. From March of 2013, this city has worked on this.
Lawmakers and a crowded chamber of business and bike owners are either going to strike a balance or ride off in their own directions. Some say the compromise offers cover for business interests who want to stop the bike lane. Others are open to tweaking, even if it costs anywhere from 40 to 100 grand. City engineers say a single lane along here carries anywhere from 700 to 1,000 cars an hour.
And choking that down to a one lane each direction 19 hours out of the day, in my opinion, is a bad idea.
Daily bike riders like Michael Goldsmith consider it a symbol of progress, an alternative to the car commute. Now those business owners say when they first got wind of the project last fall, the decision had already been made, so they feel run over by a plan that they say left them out of the loop until now. Live at City Hall, John London, WLWT News 5.
All right, John London, very good. And if council wants to change the bike lane plan, they have to do so. They have to do this by May 2nd, or they risk the loss of federal funding by the project or for the project.